Happiness runs in a circular motion. Thought is like a little boat upon the sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. You can have everything if you let yourself be. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs in a circular motion. Thought is like a little boat upon the sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. You can have everything if you let yourself see. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs.
And 70-year-old Galileo Galilei, son of Vincenzo Galilei of Florence, now deceased. Galileo has been brought up on charges of heresy.
Go.
Approaching the defendant stand is Pope Urban VIII, who by the divine powers of poetic license and anachronism is appearing here in Rome at the Palace of the Holy Office, hypothetically and spiritually. His metaphorical magnificence has demanded that all copies of Galileo's Dialogue Concerning the Two Chief World Systems, written 1632, be seized and inspected by the Inquisition Board.
Here to oversee the trial proceedings approaches Commissary General and Reverend Father Fra Vincenzo Macalano of Firenzola and his assistant Reverend Father Carlos Incari, Prosecutor of the Holy Office.
Trial commence.
I would just like to say that this is an outrage. How dare this heathen mock us so?
If I might have a word about
No, that. You may not have a word. Your word is not as good as mine. Not only did this heretic dare to satirize me as a foolish character in his dialogue, but he's also a supporter of the Copernican heliocentric theory.
Heliocentric system, a universal structure in which the sun is the center, and everything, including the earth, revolves around it. Manamana. But this is evil because it is not what is said in the Bible.
Manamana.
This is also called the Copernican system, since it was first hypothesized by Copernicus. But his work was never published until he was on the verge of death.
Manamana.
A lesson to you all, never disagree Manamana. With the Pope unless you are dead.
I assure you, I have gained conclusive documented evidence having observed the orbits of the moons of Jupiter. The movements do not justify even crystal sphere theory. A shooting star will shatter no glass as it passes through what were once supposedly glass segments of the galaxy. The movements of planetary satellite orbits do not justify a geocentric system as gazed through a telescope.
And what sort of witchcraft is this telescope, you madman?
Objection! Irrelevant!
Forgive me, Lord. Might I remind the court of the geocentric system?
Geocentric system. The only plausible solution according to the all-powerful Catholic Church, which obviously makes it right. The Earth is the center of the universe. Everything else,
Phenomena.
Including the sun, revolves around the Earth.
Phenomena.
People look up to the heavenly bodies from the center of the universe on Earth.
This is the structure of the heavens according to the Bible.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Not even elliptical orbits have their place here.
That's not nice.
Yeah! I see a call to the witness stand.
Yes, I would like to call upon Galileo's daughter, Suor Maria Celeste.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Sister, that is quite a nasty habit of yours.
Really? I think it's rather nice.
At least you can agree that your father's quite a nasty habit of his own.
I don't believe my father has any habits. Although I would imagine if he did, they would look quite ghastly in comparison to his honorable figure.
Exactly.
But I assure you, my habits are my own. My habits are not my father's.
So your habits make you a good nun and Christian?
My habits are God's gift. They are pure as silk, white as light, deep blue as the life-sustaining waters.
An intelligible answer for a woman.
You would be surprised. I write to my father as often as I can from San Mateo Convent.
Well, next time, you be sure to remind him of his ghastly habits.
Why, certainly.
That is all, Judge. Sister, you've done well. Take your wonderful habits with you.
I live to serve the Lord if you ever continue to polish my good habits. Oh, love you, Daddy. I hope my uncanny intelligence is enough to serve your cause.
With that, Judge, I'd like to bring this issue to a close.
I don't get a chance to explain myself?
No!
After months' deliberation and various depositions and meetings that seemed like only minutes, on this day, June 22nd, 1633, we, the Holy Office, charge you, Galileo, with heresy in violation of Inquisition law, back from 1616, having taught and written extensively on the Copernican theory, having treated such theories as real models and not mathematical ideas, and for your own beliefs in such hypothetical theories.
Galileo, you have been issued an ultimatum. Either revoke your teachings or suffer holy penalty. Side effects may include house arrest, excommunication, and/or death. Anything you have to say for yourself?
Thank you.